So next one is server side request forgery. So this is the ability of a user to trigger requests from within our server for various purposes. A common purpose here is to run a port scanning within our server and figure out which services we are running together with the API. So of course we are running an API server within the server, but maybe we have also a database, maybe we have some configuration system that are running within the server, they are listening on a port, and a user may figure out those services are running inside and maybe they can get access to them. So the way they will do this is, there are some situations in which we have to ask our users for input in the form of URLs so that we can pull content from that URL. Imagine, for example, we have a process to set up the profile of our users and we ask them to provide a URL for the profile picture, so a gravatar or something like that. And then a malicious user may figure out they can leverage this feature to include requests to the local host with different ports to see, analyze the response time and the type of response they get back to see what services are running inside of our box. And so they may try launching a request like here in this example to the default Postgres server. And if they get, if the Postgres is running, you launch an HTTP request, we're gonna get a reply that is an empty reply from the server. If that response leaks through the API and the user sees that, they will figure out we have a Postgres service running inside our server. Let me try to get access to that. So the point here is that they can leverage this information to build a profile of our services and plan and launch attack against our API. So what do you think, Frank, we can do here?
Well, I think from a design perspective, we can have the concept at least within the implementation of the design that we would have an allow list or a green list of domains that we would accept in that particular property, and or apply some regex patterns to ensure that it's a correctly formed URL and some other type of injection. And I would say, secondly, we should also, if we know that it's going to be a URL, then if we have the ability to run it through some form of security scanner before we persist it or execute on top of it, that would be also very, very good.